Now let us talk about errors and exceptions handling in Python. So errors are nothing but syntax errors. For example, in this case, I say I equal to 0, okay? And let's say I want to concatenate I with some string. Syntactically, it is not correct. And you can see here, it give type error, okay? Exceptions are runtime exceptions. So it will compile, but when you try to run, it will fail. For example, let's say I want to divide I with 0, okay? Even though it is throwing exception immediately, it is actually a kind of a runtime exception. But in Python, because it is an interpreter programming language, it actually throw it as errors only, okay? The common types of errors are like zero division error, which we have seen here. Another common type of error is, let's exit from here, because I have created so many variables with regular names which I have been using. Launch Python here, and 4 is an integer plus x, and I want to multiply that with 5 and add it with 4. Because x is not defined, it will give name error. So if you try to use the variables which are not defined, you will get the name error. Also, if you try to concatenate with a string like x in this case, it will give type error. So we have name error, type error, and zero division error. These are the few of the common errors or exceptions which we might see. In Python, it does not differentiate much between error and exception, unlike other programming language where errors are at compile time and exceptions are at runtime. Because in Python, it's an interpreter-based programming language, and hence, most of these exceptions comes at runtime only. Okay. So that being said, because there is no compilation phase in between, we can use try-catch to catch these errors, and if an error or exception happens, if you want to take a particular action, you can use try catch. Okay, so let me show you. So I'm saying while true, it will keep on iterating until there is exit point. And try catch is, it has to start with try block first. So in this, you will write the code. Let's say x equal to int input. So this actually takes the input from the console, and then please enter a number. So it will prompt you to enter a number, okay, and then break. So if you enter a number which is not integer, so if you enter something which is not integer, in that case I want to capture the value error. The logic which I am developing is, it will ask you to enter something. As long as you enter a number, it will keep on prompting you that invalid number, etc. And once you enter a number, it will print that number and it will get out of it, okay? So that's the logic which we are trying to build here. So here we'll get to the break only if the number is integer, because I am using int to construct the value. Unless I enter a valid number, it will not get to the break. It will get to the value error. So if it is value error, I want to print the message. Oops, it is not valid number. Try again. Okay. So this is the message which you will get. If you get any other exception, such as runtime error. So for whatever reason, you got this runtime error or type error or name error. Okay. So if any of these exceptions occur, then I just want to pass. I don't want to come out of it. I don't want to break. So I just have to use a function called pass here and hit enter. Now you see it is prompting for a number. If I say A or Z and hit enter, it is not a valid number and hence it's failing. So it is actually giving a value error. Now if I say 0, because it's a valid number, it just came out of it. Okay. So this is how you can use try catch block to catch the exceptions and act accordingly based upon the exception that is generated. Okay. So if you try to assign a value by converting a string into integer like this, because Z is not of type integer, it is actually throwing value error. That's why we are getting into this exception. So based upon the type of exception your code execute, you have to define those things and you have to act accordingly. Okay. And now there is another block which is nothing but finally, along with try and except. So finally, always execute whether it is success or failure. So for example, in this case, let's say whether it is success or failure, I want to print whatever you have typed. Okay. In that case, I have to define this logic while true and then try, and rest of the stuff is same. And then I can define finally. So finally typically is used for cleaning up whatever needs to be cleaned. For example, if you are trying to connect a database to get certain information from the database, and if you want to close the connection, whether you are successful in getting the data from the database or not, you have to close the connection. And those type of scenarios we use finally. So in this case, I am just saying finally, and then let's say print, you have typed string of x and hit enter. Okay, now it is asking for number, let's say a. Okay, probably because I am saying int of input, and it might be typecasting, converting that value to 0. into X, and as I am trying to print that X, it might be throwing this. Yeah, so that is the reason why. Because it is throwing exception, it is actually assigning a value 0, because we are using int to build X. Even though it is throwing exception, X is assigned to 0, and hence mentioned you have type put 0 here. Okay, but if I change this code a bit, so again I'm starting with while. I just want to see what I have typed. So while true, try. So first let me take the input, okay, and then I equal to int of X, and then break, and then accept value error. Okay, and now if I say yeah, now you got, oops, it is not a valid number, but it said you have typed a. Okay, so if you just want to see what you have been typing, in every iteration the finally will be executed. When it comes to accept, whatever exception raised, based on that the particular accept will be executed, but finally will be executed every time. So this is very effectively used while writing the JDBC code. If you establish a connection to the database and if you get the data, sometimes you might be successful in getting the data, sometimes you might be failed to get the data for whatever reason. In either of the cases, you might have to close the cursor or database connection, etc. And in those scenarios, finally has to be used so that we write our code effectively.